Hi, this is Brad from Pro Wrestling Junkies, and welcome to the debut episode of Steven and Brad's Talkin Wrestling. Each week, we'll review a movie or a TV show that's related to wrestling, and we'll give our opinions. We also have some other fun things planned. But let's talk to my co-host today, Mr. Steven Spice. Steven, how are you?
I'm doing perfectly fine.
You look good, for at least better than me. Did you shave, or do you normally not have hair on your face?
I normally don't have hair on my face.
Got it. Okay, so now we know a little bit more about you. Why don't you tell us something about yourself other than your hair problem?
First of all, I don't think it's a problem.
No, I guess. I mean, fine. We can talk about that off air. I don't know anything about science and biology.
So I love wrestling, like, all over the world. I don't care what wrestling show it is. I don't care if it's New Japan. I don't care any wrestling show I will go to if I have the chance to. But lately, I haven't been able to go to wrestling, so I'm getting a little down. So I don't know what to do because there's no wrestling shows on. Unless it's WWE, because I like watching the pre-town shows, if you know what that is.
And did you tell me when you appeared on Getting to Know a Junkie, did you tell me you're into Tom and Jerry as well?
Yeah, I love Tom and Jerry.
Are you looking forward to the movie that's coming out?
Wait, there's a WWE movie from
Oh my gosh, there's a Tom and Jerry movie coming out on, I think, the very beginning of March.
That's my brother's birthday month.
Yeah, it looks really good. My boys want to see it.
Is it a WWE movie for Tom and Jerry?
No. It's just a straight up Thomas and Jerry.
Tom and Jerry, not Tom.
I know. Well, okay. All right, let me tell you a little bit myself. I'm originally from Chicago, Illinois, and I moved down to Champaign, Illinois about a year ago. It's about 2 hours south of Chicago. I started watching wrestling on November 2nd, 1985. And I remember that because it was a Saturday night's main event. So I was able to find the actual date. I'm currently a stay-at-home dad while my kids are home virtually schooling. And despite what you've heard, I didn't invent the iPhone or electricity. I have two kids. Sometimes they're great. And finally, a few things I hate are tomatoes, unmelted cheese, and the Chicago Cubs. So that's me in a nutshell.
You don't like unmelted cheese?
No, it's got to be melted for me.
I love any type of cheese.
Yeah, I'm in the minority in my home. Everyone else seems to like cheese. Do you have any dislikes we should know about?
Let's see. I dislike Ricochet and Paige.
Okay. So there's another human out there that you can't stand.
Oh, trust me, there's a lot of humans that I can't stand.
Yeah, no. Are you more of an animal fan or a human fan?
Human fan, because I have Channing Decker, I have Aiden Prince, I have John Cena, I have...
Yeah.
I'm going for days.
All right, well, speaking of having an enemy or something you hate. Can you give us a 60-second promo this morning to get us started?
Sure. So it's a rant pretty much. So I don't like how the Bella Twins are coming to the Hall of Fame, but the John Cena and The Rock are coming to the Hall of Fame. How does that make sense? John Cena and The Rock are Hall of Famers. They should be going on forever. Or Christian.
Your temper is intimidating. Your anger. I totally agree with that. And I never even thought about that. So, will the Bella Twins be going in this year?
Last year.
They went in last year. Okay. So, are you glad that you got that out of your system now?
Oh wait, hey, 2020 was the worst year of the season.
Oh yeah, it's been the worst year.
Bella Twins got abducted, can't go to wrestling shows. What else?
Yeah, you can't go out to like restaurants or to the movie theaters.
Oh, technically my home is a movie theater because we watch movies at nighttime.
Oh, nice. Do you watch on that TV behind you?
Yeah.
Awesome. All right, Steven. So today we're going to be reviewing the first episode of Hulk Hogan's Rockin' Wrestling, which debuted in September, on September 14th, 1985. So 35 years ago, a little more. Did you think the animation was strange compared to like what you see now on regular TV shows?
Like Tom and Jerry? I think
that
it was pretty much everything different apart. Like the new Tom and Jerry movie would be so much different because everything is upgraded.
Yeah.
That was in the 1990s or something.
Mm-hmm.
So everything from 2021 is upgraded from the 1990s.
Yeah. Yeah, so that's a little hard to, but that's what your parents and I, that was the best animation when we were growing up.
Yeah.
So the first, let's talk about this episode. Okay, well, that brings back a ton of memories from when I was a little boy.
Can I talk about something first? Is that okay with you?
Absolutely. This is all about you.
When I was watching episode one, why would they not use Roddy Piper's voice? Like, can they just get Roddy Piper to act in the show? Because his voice was so off.
Exactly. And I thought Junkyard Dog's voice was very gravelly.
Yeah, they're just all of them are just so different.
So each episode, I guess, is two episodes in each. So the first one was the Junkyard 500.
Wait, well, except for Hulk Hogan, he wasn't different. That was the same.
Yeah. So the Junkyard 500 is the first part of this episode. Can you do a quick rundown of kind of what happened?
The first, like, this was like, I don't know how to explain it. It's like, it's so much like a show where there's like two episodes combined, but it's episode one. So right. The first time of the episode was a movie theater. So they all tried, and then Roddy Piper won the race. There was a race to try to get in the movie. So they all tried, Roddy Piper won, and karma hits, boy. Karma hits. His car got crushed.
Destroyed.
And one thing about the show that I wanted to say.
Sure.
How come Hulk Hogan never said brother in the whole thing?
Okay, that's what I was going to say that too. And he was barely in either of the two shows on the episode.
And this whole show.
The first one, he came in at about 5 minutes in, did his thing for about a minute, and then we never saw him again.
No, he actually was in the stage cheering for Junkyard Dog.
Oh,
and
okay.
And then we never saw him again.
But for the star of his show, I would have thought he'd been on a little more, but maybe he's modest.
See, the thing I think is every episode there will be a famous star, and one episode will be just him.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Because Junkyard Dog... That's surprising that both of the episodes were Junkyard Dog.
Yeah. So maybe you're right, like that each episode focuses, bless you.
Thank you.
On one specific character. I thought that it was, bless you. I thought that it was very strange, two things. One, that Hulk Hogan, when he was on, was wearing his belt out in public. And then the other thing I thought was kind of strange was that Junkyard Dog wasn't wearing a shirt, but Nikolai Volkoff was wearing a long sleeve turtleneck. So I couldn't tell what the temperature was. I don't even know why I was thinking about that.
Yeah, so what, wait, it looks like it's in summer or spring.
Yeah.
But
I think they would have shown snow, I guess, if it was
like winter.
Yeah. And another interesting thing was, you know, at the beginning when Junkyard Dog crashed onto that movie set.
Yeah.
With the car. Mm-hmm. He hit someone. No one called the ambulance or anything.
Wait. It's a cartoon. Just to say that.
I know. I know. Like,
just a hammer. Bah, 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 bah.
I know. So, you're putting me in my place.
Plus, I want to know something.
Sure.
How in the world did he hit him, right? He landed in the garbage, right?
Yes, yes.
So how did he land where the thing was over his leg? The lid was over his leg. Are those fake legs or something?
Oh, that's a good point.
Are they like cushioned legs so they don't get crushed?
Maybe they don't have bones.
Why does his legs not have bones?
Did you think it was strange that when they were... when they were working on Roddy Piper's car, that Mr. Fuji was under his car fixing it, but wearing a tuxedo?
Yeah, because I think that would be smart, because if any of the dust gets on you, no one will see it.
Oh, you make a good point. No one would see oil if it spilled on.
Yeah.
Okay, you're making several good points.
See, I'm sorry that I'm not a big, like, old school fan. I don't really, I know a lot of old school people, but I don't know some of them. So, who was the girl that was on top of Mr. Fuji that got sprayed in the face with oil?
Okay, that would be... So, I wore my Hulk Hogan Rock and Wrestling shirt.
No,
that,
can you send me one of those?
Yeah, sure, why not? What color?
Blue. My favorite color is blue.
Just like this? This color blue?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it was Fabulous Moolah who was the woman.
Oh, the woman that was in the thing with Mr. Fuji that was talking to her?
Exactly.
I think that ain't no makeup gonna fix that face.
No, no, she's a lost cause.
She's one of a kind.
Yeah. She probably looks her worst first thing in the morning without the makeup on.
But when she puts the makeup on, she's... yeah, no.
Yeah, no, she's... You don't imagine one day marrying somebody like the Fabulous Moolah. I'm getting...
Nope.
Okay, good. So the second episode, or second part of the first episode, was another Junkyard Dog, and this one was called Junkenstein.
Yeah.
Or Junkenstein, or whatever.
Junkenstein. Okay.
So what happened in that one, if you could remind me?
So they were Junkyard was telling stories to Andre, and Andre was like, which I don't get. He's like,
yeah.
And really,
you know, like, I noticed that too. And maybe it's like, you know how elephants are scared of mice?
Wait, what?
Elephants are scared of, you know, little tiny mice. So maybe, that's how Andre the Giant felt. He was the elephant, and the story he was being told was the mouse.
Okay, so
go on.
What I don't get is, he's a big giant, like, eighth wonder of the world thing.
Yeah.
Right? So why can't he just, if anything comes after him, get up and be like, you really want to mess with me still?
Yeah, he was the biggest wrestler around, like, one of the biggest people in the world. I was a little shocked he was getting that scared.
But I think it was part of this, like, I think they did that because one reason. Hmm. One reason and one reason only.
Okay.
He was afraid of snakes in his real time.
Great point. Yes, so I forgot about that.
I think that they made the book the snake.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's perfect sense. That's a great way to explain it. So he's telling him this scary story. And what happens after that?
So he bumps into one of those pillars, like the little wooden pillars. They're nothing. So he bumps into one, and the shells fall, and he finds some junk. And he builds into a freaking robot, and then he pushes it up to the electric, and it was like...
Why did he build it to begin with?
Because Andre made a big mess in his house.
Okay. Okay.
I think Roddy is rotten to the core. Because they put his disc in, if you remember.
Yes.
Andre got... and put his disc in.
Mm-hmm.
So he went all nuts. He was being rude. So I think he's rotten to the core.
Yeah, I think he took on Roddy Piper's personality.
See, John, this is real wrestling. This is actually real wrestling.
Sure. So,
when Roddy was around, I don't get why they made him a heel. He was a Canadian. Why would they make him a heel?
That's true, and he was the biggest heel.
Yeah, why? Like,
they needed somebody who could talk to talk back to Hulk Hogan.
No, I think I know why.
Why?
One to talk back from Hulk Hogan.
Uh-huh.
One big heel from Canada. One big face from Canada. Because Bret Hart and Roddy Piper. Didn't they have a fight?
Yeah, I think at WrestleMania they had an Intercontinental Championship match.
So I think that was why they needed him a heel for Star Wars. They needed him to grow up first. Grow, and then he'll fight Bret Hart.
Got it. Makes perfect sense, Steven. So he gets this robot made, which I didn't know how he had all the parts or the technology to do that. What happens? And they get the Roddy Piper disc into the robot. He goes nuts. And then what happens?
Wait, before I tell you.
Mm-hmm.
So there was a mannequin, right? So he looks at the mannequin. Where was the mannequin? Where'd the mannequin go?
Oh, yeah. What do you think? What are your thoughts on that?
I think the mannequin stuffed inside it. I think Andre went like, CPR.
And it exploded into a million pieces.
Yeah.
I think,
I don't know why Andre shouldn't have just, when he put the vampire cloak on, pick it up like they did in the Deadpool movie.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So the robot takes off.
I think his hand, in real life, his hand will be as big as my head.
Oh, for sure. Easy. So what happens after he flips out? Bless you.
Sorry, I have a lot of sneezing.
Don't worry. Get them all out.
I sleep beside a rag.
So he flees the junkyard. He goes to, and he gets a job, correct?
Yeah. Bless you. He doesn't really get a job. He just stole the food tray and dumped it on.
Oh, okay. At the drive-thru.
And then he went inside and started flipping the patties everywhere.
Okay. So you don't think he was actually an employee there?
No.
Okay.
I don't think they would ever hire someone like that.
So the junkyard dog gets to the drive-thru, and what happens then?
One thing I don't... Wait. He has a wheel. The robot has a wheel. Mm-hmm. They only had... Okay. So, I guess, but I don't get it. Because a car is like 500 pounds.
Yeah,
and
more.
When Ron lifted up that ambulance, right?
Yeah.
Or Slambulance as the toy.
Mm-hmm.
So, when he did that, why didn't... That was fake. It was just like foam and stuff. It was
correct.
Fake. There's no way a human could lift up as
ambulance. Absolutely not. I've never seen anybody do that, just like a normal person.
Okay, maybe a 1% chance it was real.
Yeah, okay, leave 1% for just in case.
Okay, so how did they lift up a 100-pound car?
Mm-hmm. Probably 1,000 pounds.
Yeah, how? Like, with only two arms from each man.
Yeah, I'm not sure about their strength or the cars. I think it was sometimes I've heard like when someone gets a lot of adrenaline, like a lot of energy, they could lift a car.
Yeah, I don't think so.
No, I don't see myself being able to one day lift any
lift
type
up a
of
couch.
Vehicle.
I can lift up a couch.
Oh, that's impressive.
Wait,
I don't think I can.
You can lift up a bike?
Me?
Yeah.
I have a very bad back. No, a bike I definitely could, but
no, like a motorcycle.
A couch I couldn't.
Really? What kids are
making that? I have to have the children take care of that stuff to get the crayons and stuff from under the couch and crumbs and such. So
actually, only because when we need to find a wrestler, see if any wrestler would shoot it from these.
Sure. So Junkyard Dog shows up to the drive-through, and he realized that rock and roll music makes the robot short circuit. Correct?
Because Riot Hammer doesn't like rock and roll. He only likes the
He doesn't do well with like a heavy bass.
One thing I think they should have done, even though he's not a wrestler, mm-hmm. like a full wrestler.
Yeah.
It should have been Mr. T, right? That was one of the main characters. Yeah. It should have been Mr. T.
I'm surprised he wasn't in that. He was a big deal at that time, especially in wrestling. So how does it end?
So how it ends is, so Roddy Piper gets like, oh, wait, which one?
Drunkenstein.
Okay. So how it ends is, he on the strip circuit is, and then they take out the disc. And now he's all full and ready to clean, and he puts a little vampire cloak on him for a joke. Andre was like, nope, not happening. And then he's like, come on, it was just a joke. And he's like,
the episode concludes with some beauty tips from your favorite Fabulous Moolah. Did you learn anything, take anything away from her beauty session? Like, will you be wearing lipstick and makeup going forward?
No.
Okay. All right. That was the correct answer. Would you, on a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rank the episode as far as entertainment purposes?
1 to 10. Mm-hmm.
Probably, 10 being you loved it, 1 being...
I think it would be an 8, because there's some losses from the voice and the cartoon texture.
Sure. I you know, I was going to give it like a 7. So we're kind of basically on the same page with that.
Why do you give it a 7?
Because of, one, the animation, just because I'm not, we're not used to that anymore. And 2, because Junkyard Dog's car hit someone and no one called the ambulance. That was the other, I dropped it a point for that as well.
Wait, actually, I think I'm going to give it a 9 because the animation is not their fault. They had no fixing that.
Yeah, you're right. And we talked about that earlier, that that was like the best animation at the time.
So, yeah, so I'm going to give it a 9.
Would you watch another episode again?
Yeah.
Sounds like you would. Okay.
It's really good.
Steven, we will get to what we're reviewing next week, but go on.
Sorry for stopping you. Mm-hmm. I think one thing would be, I forgot what I was going to say. Darn it. Wait, if Hulk Hogan was not in the next episode, I will be upset and pissed.
Ooh, okay. I don't like seeing this side of you.
It's his own show. So why isn't he in this first or second episode?
Yeah, he was in like 5 minutes of the entire, not even. He was in like 1 minute total. But you know what? When we watch episode 2, we'll be able to see if they start bringing him on more. Again, though, I thought he would be in the first episode a lot.
Yeah, because like, it's Hulk and Hogan. It's Hulk and Hogan. Sure.
So, Steven, is there something today that you could teach me or teach our audience?
I'm going to teach everyone. Well, probably not everyone, because some people go to the wrestling indies. So this is something that's from Greektown and WWE. WWE doesn't do violence anymore. There's no barbed wire matches, barbed wire chairs. Greektown is the other opposite of it. There's barbed wire, there's chairs, there's tables, there's doors, there's everything you can imagine. I got a whole white chair covered in their, I don't know how to explain this. You know how I say the
yes.
red stuff?
Yes, I know what you're talking about.
Covered in B-word. So, yeah. That's only from Japanese deathmatch.
I've also got
a whole table that's with their whole B-word on it.
Oh, really?
From Sabu and Channing Decker.
Oh, my gosh. Is that something
they
that
jumped
you...
off a balcony.
Is that something that you, like, keep in some type of protective case?
Actually, no. Because there's a shelf right where the table is, so mm-hmm. it's not falling anytime soon.
Okay. Are you a fan of watching death matches? I'm not. I'm a little squeamish.
I am.
Oh, okay.
One part of that Mexican death, like, I've done two death matches. One Mexican, where those pinatas and everything, one was filled with Lego. Uh-huh. That was my first match.
Really?
It was my first time seeing a live event.
And did you like it right away?
Oh, I loved it. I was like, get the tables!
So oh my.
One time at a wrestling show,
uh-huh.
It was not a death match.
Okay.
It was just a regular match. But it wasn't a regular match. It was like a hardcore match.
Okay.
So I was like, get the tables. And everyone's like, he wants the tables. Everyone in the whole stadium was like,
oh my God.
He wants the tables. So they actually got a table out.
And did it feel great knowing that they were all referring to you? Everyone in the arena?
Oh, and one time I felt happier than the happiest man alive.
Okay, let's hear this.
It was at this show called Chinlock. I don't know if you've ever been to one.
No.
You've never been to a Chinlock. You need to get to the next one.
Tell me about this. I need to know.
So, last year you got to meet Bret Hart.
Okay.
Mark Henry. Hornswoggle.
Oh, wow.
Lex Luger, but he wasn't supposed to be there. It was supposed to be someone else.
Okay.
Arn Anderson that was supposed to be there.
Okay.
Sorry. Toby Blanchard. But okay. Lex, he couldn't show up, so Lex Luger came.
That's not bad. Lex Luger.
No, it's not bad at all. So, the referee that Jimmy the Mouth himself, yes, and the ref that refed one of Undertaker's matches.
Okay.
Jimmy the Kid Harris.
Oh, yeah.
And this year, they're planning on Shawn Michaels coming. Oh, and I forgot. Last year, Billy Gunn came.
Oh, cool.
And Tommy Dreamer.
I like Tommy Dreamer.
So, this year it's Kane, maybe.
Huh? Oh, wow.
Shawn Michaels.
Even if you stopped right there, that would be impressive.
No. There's
bigger names?
No, there's like... Ted DiBiase might be there.
Oh, cool.
So, basically, it's like... Five people lined up. Five Hall of Famers lined up.
And where do you see this?
Kingston. Last year was so good. It was my first Chinlock show.
Okay.
But it was the best Chinlock show. Because I was in the biggest hotel uh-huh. in Kingston.
Okay.
I was in the hotel where the superstars were living.
Like just coincidentally?
Yeah.
Wow. So were you constantly seeing like wrestlers like in the lobby?
I got an arm wrestle Mark Henry.
Oh my God. Did you win?
Well, I went out of it. I went out of it because I don't want my arm to break.
Yeah. He could easily snap that thing off.
It was like,
he could probably break it just by blinking. He's that strong.
Probably just like.
So, Stephen, go on.
I'm sorry for interrupting. I've interrupted
you
a lot.
You interrupt all you want.
So, last year, mm-hmm. My mom loves Hornswoggle.
Okay.
It's her favorite wrestler because he's so small. Yeah. Well, I think we both love her, him, because he's, like, so funny.
Yeah.
So last year, I was like, "Where's what was coming in?" He's like, "What?" I was like, "Never mind." And so we were looking at the window. I saw Mark Henry coming into the hotel, Billy Gunn coming into the hotel.
So did you go up to try and get like a picture or an autograph?
I was actually in the lobby right in the morning where I had to wake up. Billy Gunn and Tommy Dreamer were talking to each other in the lobby.
So did you go up to them?
My shirts were like, Degeneration X.
Yeah.
On the front. And on the end it said, Tommy Dreamer or something. No, on Liam's, on the front.
Okay.
It's a Degeneration X, so technically it's on the front, it's rooting for Billy Gunn and Tommy Dreamer.
Because
Billy
Gunn. Yeah, yeah.
They were having a tag team match against Tyson Dukes and Terror. But on the back, it was a mystery. It was this, the front was a whole mystery. It was a trick.
Okay.
So on the back, it said, Tyson's gonna kill you.
Oh.
And then Liam's, it said, T-Rex gonna kill you. And Chinlock.
So.
It made me so upset because it made Tyson look like a little baby. Because he ran to T-Rex and hugged his waist.
So have you seen one of these shows during like the pandemic?
No.
No.
I might see one during the pandemic this year.
Because
I want to meet Kane and Shawn Michaels if they're there.
You should just move to... Go on.
My mom's thinking about moving to Kingston.
Where is Kingston? Like, how far away?
4 hours away.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So you wouldn't fly there, right? You'd drive.
Yeah.
So, okay.
One thing about Timlock is it was so funny on World Cross Smash. He was fighting Andre City. So Swallow's gonna kill you. Swallow's gonna kill you. And he's both like, Hornswoggle was like, with his handgun. And then he's like, no. Jimmy Kidderis?
Okay.
Like, no, give me that gun. No. No. He puts it away. And he's like, no. And he's like, with a shotgun.
Now, is your mom there with you?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
She wouldn't miss a day in the world to meet Hornswoggle.
So, Stephen, inadvertently...
But this year, it's sad because only me and my dad can go because we have puppies.
You have what?
We have puppies, and we have to take care of them.
How many puppies do you have?
3.
Are you keeping them permanently?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, what kind of dogs are they?
CG. CG.
Okay, and are they potty trained yet?
No.
I mean, not to use a toilet, but...
No, they're not, because we don't really take them out that much because of the pandemic.
Yeah. And I imagine it's probably pretty cold where you are, too.
It really is, and they're really small.
So do you take your dog ever on your dogs on a walk?
They're probably this big, right here.
Oh, really? Can you carry all 3 of them, like... Or is that too heavy?
Jody's too fat.
Okay.
Jody's like...
Is Jody in the room with you?
Jody's named after a wrestler. I think she is. Oh, yeah, she's right there. I'm on my mom's leg.
And does she look offended after you disparaged her, calling her fat?
No, she's actually lazy.
Okay, so she's not... You didn't hurt her feelings. Go on.
No, she actually loves to... She doesn't, we don't really see her eat that much, so I don't know why she's bloated. So, I don't really, hot dogs, I don't really eat one piece. Mm-hmm. So I give all 3 of them one piece, because I usually get 3 hot dogs.
Yeah.
So, that's actually nice a treat. That's a treat for them.
That's very generous. Stephen, you inadvertently taught us 2 things. The second being about chin lock, which I had no idea. So thank you.
You really need to go next year. This year.
I think it's time you and I do a little role play. Shall we do that?
CM Punk and John Cena.
Yeah. All right. Let's get into it. Do I have everybody's attention now? I feel a little bit of recapping is in order. If you didn't see the show last week, and I didn't watch either because I wasn't on it, I was suspended by Vincent K. McMahon. I was suspended because the week prior to that, I got in a little bit of trouble for some of the things I said. I didn't get in trouble because I announced on July 17th, my contract ends. I didn't just get in trouble because I said, not only am I going to defeat Steven, but that I was going to leave with the oh-so-precious WWE title, making all future champions completely irrelevant. I didn't get in trouble because of this little nugget that when Vince McMahon dies, the company will fall into the hands of his idiotic daughter and his son-in-law, who I believe I referred to as a doofus. I got in trouble because I said things that nobody else has the balls to say. Things like this company inside and outside the ring are filled with a parade of shameless ass kissers. But never fear, tonight, not only am I reinstated, not only is my championship back with Steven back on, I brought backup just in case. They cut off my microphone, just in case. So a lot of you are probably wondering why I'm holding a live microphone. So I'm going to tell you right now, Vince McMahon very much wants to re-sign me to a very long-term, very lucrative contract with World Wrestling Entertainment. It's fine to me that Vince is bending over backwards to give me everything I've ever wanted when all I've ever wanted was this little microphone. See, this is power. This voice is power. If anybody else's hands, this is just a microphone. In my hands, it's a pipe bomb, as I showed you 2 weeks ago. So Vince McMahon finally sees me for what I am, and that is the hottest property in the industry today. He finally sees that the way, because I did something that he and his empty suits could not do. I made WWE socially relevant, and not you people. I mean the real world. In the real world, the WWE has always got a mention or two for two reasons. The first one being that Brad is speaking his mind. The second one is because somebody died. It's true. But now that WWE, because of me, is all over YouTube, I'm a YouTube sensation. ESPN is trying to get me to do an interview with one of their radio shows. Jimmy Kimmel's people have been ringing my phone trying to get me on the hook. They just want to know what I have to say. They're begging for my story. And I find that funny that I have one foot out the door and Vince McMahon wants to give me everything I want. If Vince McMahon was this nice 5 years ago, I wouldn't have 5 years of pent-up ammunition on him. I wouldn't have to say so much. I know Vince McMahon, and I know how he does business. He's going to come here and expect me to sit down and have a man-to-man conversation with him about a contract. But I also know he likes to do things that have never been done before. So I say, Vince McMahon, tonight, we have the first ever live contract negotiation in the ring. And who knows, maybe I'll sign, and maybe I won't. But Vince McMahon will have to join something I like to call the Brad Kiss My Ass Club.
First of all, before I start talking, you think you're getting this title, which you aren't. That's one. Two, you want to talk where, what were you saying?
Hey, everybody, it's Steven. Thank you for getting me reinstated to a job I didn't even really want in the first place. Thank you for giving me everything I have ever wanted. Not only am I going to beat you, and when I beat you, I'm probably going to change the way it looks because that thing has been far too ugly for far too long. You made a couple of things completely real. Come Sunday, I'm leaving. I will beat you for the title, and I will leave. And now when I beat you, you're going to get fired? Let's go to Chicago, and I can beat you for the title. But if you think Vince McMahon is really going to fire you, I'd like to take you back a few months ago when you were fired, and it lasted all of, what, 7 days? So you don't even have to worry about that.
You're done. You're done.
Let's be honest. Probably not. I've got a megaphone if you want.
I just wanted to make sure you got it all out because you made a very thoughtful, truthful statement for above 5 years. We've been wrestling to find, waiting to find out you actually have a set of balls to congratulations. You also have a mouth, and apparently you like to run it, but I'm here to set you straight because for 5 months I've heard it's how you're walking out of Chicago with the WWE Championship. You gotta go through me to do it. You just act like I'm some sort of pushover, like it doesn't matter who you face because your microphone Brad, and you've got a live microphone and nobody's gonna stop you. Well, I've got news for you, Jack. I'm not a pushover. I know for why you talking, you're thinking, because I was halfway out cold when you were on the stage saying you were the best wrestler in the company.
The best wrestler in the world.
Congratulations. You got a set of balls, a big mouth, and self-confidence. But vision of... You also said that I am the vision of what this company thinks. The best should be because I prance around to all the appearances and smile because the camera. I do that because I love it. I am the best. It because I have this and I earned it. And you think you are the best wrestler? Congratulations for thinking that. There is a lot of people who thought that names. Everyone has dreams. Like Triple H, John Layfield, Batista, Randy Orton, and Kurt Angle. Shawn Michaels, even the late Eddie Guerrero thought, the kid couldn't hang with me. He can't wrestle with me in the ring. Disappointed. Every single one was disappointed. I didn't come out here to run my mouth. I didn't care if you got a microphone or a megaphone. You're going, Vince McMahon's going to fire me, or he's full of it. I think I'm coming to Chicago and at Money in the Bank to whoop your ass.
I have your attention, please. I've received an email from the anonymous Raw General Manager. Mr. McMahon is en route to negotiate with Brad, but in the meantime, I think if this is Steven's last night on Raw, we should see him in action. So don't go anywhere, because you're going to be competing in a very special match next. Steven, you did tremendous. And next week, we might even have a special guest who joins us for our role play. A certain wrestler that I am friends with who'd like to come on. Oh. If that is okay with you, of course.
Who?
I'd leave it a surprise, or do you want me to tell you?
No, I want to know. I can't last surprise.
All right, so you'll have to go on YouTube this week and research him. His name is Paragon, and he's awesome. So you go check on YouTube and stuff, and you'll find plenty of his stuff. He's great. Especially find the stuff when he's not when he's on the microphone, because he can talk.
Okay.
All right, Steven, we're wrapping up now. Next week, what should we review?
Let's do Scooby-Doo WrestleMania.
Okay, that's a bit ambitious for us, but we have a week to get it done, and then we'll give our review.
I just watched a few months ago the same movie.
Oh, okay, so you're ahead. I have to catch up then.
A few months ago, I just watched it.
And I don't know if I should ask you this. I should form my own. I'll ask you. Is it good?
Oh,
it's awesome.
Well, it's damn true.
Okay. And it's not scary.
No, it's not scary. None of Scooby-Doo movies are scary.
Okay, and no foul language.
If they're scary to you, you're just a scaredy cat.
Got it.
If any Scooby-Doo movies are scary to you, you're just a scaredy cat.
All right, Steven, we're off until next Saturday. You have an awesome week. And we'll be back and we'll do our normal stuff.
Okay.
All right. Bye, everyone. Thank you so much.
Peace.